what are these glands, why they are responsible, okay? These we are going to discuss. And the last, we are going to discuss about the Hi everyone, hope all you are doing so well. So see, in this lecture we are going to talk about the unit physiology of reproduction, and also we are going to talk about the puberty and menopause in human, okay? This unit is related with your paper too. If I say ki like from this unit how many question has been appeared in previous year, so see, these are some questions. The first question: write a short note on acrosome during the fertilization, okay? So now see, you have to explain a proper diagram of a sperm, and then you have to explain the mechanism of acrosome, okay? Second, we have given account of hormonal regulation during the menstrual cycle in females. As you know that during the time of menses, female's body have a lots of change and influence in her hormone level, that you have to explain with the help of a suitable diagram. Next question we have, again this question is repeated. I told you so many times in my videos, the plus point with our subject is this, the question is repeated, okay? If you see, the question has been repeated. This question has been asked in 2023, and the same question also has been asked in the year of 2021, okay? Now let's start with this unit. So first we are going to talk about the male reproductive system, okay? So in male reproductive system, first, we are going to talk about the primary sex organ in male. which is testes. Then we are going to talk about the duct system. Why the need of duct system and why it is important, okay? Next, we are going to talk about the accessory glands. What are these glands, why they are responsible, okay? These we are going to discuss. And the last, we are going to discuss about the external male genitalia organ, that is penis, okay? The last, we are going to talk about the external male genital organ. So see, if I talk about the testes, we are consider it as a primary, means it is responsible for the process of gametogenesis. What is gametogenesis? The formation of gametes. We see male mein jo gametogenesis hoti hai, it have a special name, and the name is spermatogenesis. What do you understand by this terminology, spermatogenesis? That means formation of sperm. So why we consider them, this testes, as a important? Because responsible for the process of gametogenesis. Okay, agar see, aapne ek most common term suna hoga, jise hum bolte hain testicles. Do you know what is testicles? Testicles आप कब बोलोगे? When testes is attached with the epididymis. Testes plus epididymis, combinedly known as the testicles. Okay? And do you know there is a difference in both the testes? Yes, left testes is slightly lower than the right testes. Okay, which is quite normal. But see, there is no such hard and fast rule that it is going to be necessary. In most of the cases, both testes are present at the same position, okay? So write this point. So see, you can also mention this point. Left testes is slightly lower than the right one, okay? Now see the next point. See, primary organ, its gonads, that is testes, In most of the mammals, testes are extra-abdominally. See, we have most of the mammals in which testes are present outside of the body. For example, in the case of humans, these testes are not present inside of the abdomen. It is present in a sac-like structure which is known as scrotum. For example, suppose this is a scrotum, and in this scrotum, testes is present. Why they are present extra-abdominally? Because inside the temperature of body is high and it is not suitable and favorable for the process of spermatogenesis. That's why it is present outside of the body. Because if this sperm is going to be formed inside the abdomen, so because of the high temperature, sperms are unable to survive. That's why testes kahan present hoti hai? Outside of the body. Clear? Body ka temperature favorable nahi hai for this process. But yes, outside the temperature is suitable for the spermatogenesis. As you see here, because sperm produce production, maturation and storage requires 2 to 3 degree lower temperature as comparison to the body temperature. That doesn't mean 2 to 3 degrees Celsius are required, because in this temperature it is going to be freeze only, okay? And also you have to remember the some certain points in this topic where the testes formation were take place. When a male baby was in the mother's womb during the time of gestation. So when the mother have a gestation period around 7 to 8 months of pregnancy, then the testes formation take place. Okay? Jab ek male baby apni maa ke garbhashya mein hota hai, so us time jab mother ka gestation 7 to 8 week chal raha hota hai, us time pe testes banna start hota hai. Okay? So testes formation take place in the 7 to 8 week of pregnancy. The next is that jab ye banti hai, ye abdomen ke andar hi present hoti hai. But during the 7 to 8 month of pregnancy, testes migrate. Testes kya karengi? Migrate. Testes migrate and come into the scrotum. And kahan aati hai? Scrotum mein aati hai. Jab 7 to 8 week of pregnancy chala, bachche ki jo male baby hai, uske abdomen ke andar testes ka formation hua. But jaise hi 7 to 8 week of pregnancy start hua, then us time pe testes ne migrate kara and comes into the scrotum area. Clear? And see, kuch mein problem ho jati hai. Testes are unable to descend into the scrotum, and this condition is known as cryptorchidism condition. This is failure of testes to descend into the scrotum. And dekho, ye yahan par in this diagram, this is explained ki kis mein kis type ka cryptorchidism hota hai. So, jis mein abdominal, abdominal means abdomen ki andar hi kya reh gayi hai? Testes. Wo kitne percent cases mein hota hai? 15% cases mein. Jahan par inguinal canal mein testes reh jati hai, that's seen in 25% cases. And jo scrotal sac mein aake but descend nahi karti scrotum mein proper, the case is only 60%. So, cryptorchidism have two types. Ek hoti hai unilateral cryptorchidism, and the second one is bilateral cryptorchidism. Unilateral means what? One testes is present in the scrotum, another is absent. Okay? Uni means single. Bilateral means both testes are not present in the scrotum. So, us case mein kya hota hai? Jin males ke andar aisa hota hai, so they are unable to reproduce. Kyunki jo bhi sperm ka production hoga, so sperm high temperature mein survive nahi kar payenge, and it will go under the phagocytosis and they will unable to become reproduced. Clear? So unilateral hota hai and bilateral. But this condition can be treated by the help of surgery, and the name of surgery is orchidopexy. ऑर्किडोपेक्सी क्या होता है, लाइक व्हेन अ सर्जन फाउंड्स आउट दैट कि द मेल हैव दिस टाइप ऑफ अ कंडीशन, द मेल बेबी लाइक वेदर इट हैविंग अ यूनिलेटरल और हो सकता है उसे बाइलेटरल हो, सो क्या करते हैं, एब्डोमेन में कट करते हैं एंड टेस्टिस को डिसेंड करके स्क्रॉटम में लेकर आते हैं एंड द नेम ऑफ सर्जरी इज ऑर्किडोपेक्सी. सो व्हाई द ऑर्किडोपेक्सी इज डन फॉर द करेक्टिंग ऑफ द क्रिप्टोर्किडिज्म कंडीशन. ओके, एक आपने टर्म सुना होगा कैस्ट्रेक्शन, एक आप लोगों ने टर्मिनोलॉजी सुनी होगी कैस्ट्रेक्शन. कैस्ट्रेक्शन वर्ड वी आर यूजिंग इन द केस ऑफ एनिमल्स. कैस्ट्रेक्शन का मतलब होता है रिमूवल ऑफ गोनाड्स. ओके, कैस्ट्रेक्शन का मतलब होता है रिमूवल ऑफ गोनाड्स. As I told you, castration word we are uses in the case of animals. अब ये जो castration होता है ये हम animals में क्यों perform करते हैं, to make them docile. For example, can anyone tell me what is the difference between in ox and bull? Bull और ox में क्या difference होता है? Bull, they are more aggressive, yes? And उन्हें bull fights वगैरह में use किया जाता है. ऑक्स को फार्म्स वगैरह में यूज किया जाता है फॉर अ लाइक पर्पस ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. यस, तो जो बुल होते हैं व्हाई दे आर मोर एग्रेसिव, क्योंकि इनमें गोनाड्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस टेस्टोस्टेरोन लेवल इज हाई इन बॉडी. क्लियर? एंड टेस्टोस्टेरोन मेक लिटिल बिट अग्रेसिव टू द पर्टिकुलर एनिमल. अब जो बुल्स होते हैं उनमें हम क्या करते हैं, कैस्ट्रेक्शन, बुल्स के गोनाड्स को कट कर देते हैं एंड बिकम्स द ऑक्स. ओके, सो बुल में कैस्ट्रेक्शन करके क्या बना, ऑक्स बना. क्यों करते हैं हम कैस्ट्रेक्शन एनिमल्स में, टू मेक देम डोकाइल. क्या बनाने के लिए, डोकाइल. डोकाइल का मींस क्या होता है, व्हाट डज दैट मींस, टू मेक देम डोमेस्टिक. ओके, नेक्स्ट एक होती है टर्म आपकी ऑर्किडेक्टॉमी. एक टर्म होती है आपकी ऑर्किडेक्टॉमी. अब फॉर एग्जाम्पल किसी मेल्स में हमको टेस्टिस को कट करना है, वाई देर इज अ नीड टू कट आउट द टेस्टिस. मे बी द मेल इज सफर फ्रॉम द प्रोस्टेट कैंसर एंड मे बी द कैंसर इज हैपन इन देयर स्क्रॉटल रीजन. फॉर दिस कंडीशन वी रिमूव्ड आउट देयर टेस्टिस. सो मेल्स में आप ह्यूमन के केस में यू कांट यूज द टर्म कैस्ट्रेक्शन. ओके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू यूज द टर्म ऑर्किडेक्टॉमी. ऑर्की वर्ड जहां भी आप देखो समझ जाना इट इज रिलेटेड विद टेस्टिस. ओके, सो ऑर्किडेक्टॉमी मीन सर्जिकल रिमूवल ऑफ टेस्टिस. इट इज सर्जिकल रिमूवल ऑफ टेस्टिस. नेक्स्ट वी हैव इंग्यूनल हर्निया. व्हाट इज इंग्यूनल हर्निया? कुछ बच्चों में इंग्यूनल हर्निया बाय बर्थ होता है. समटाइम्स द इंग्यूनल हर्निया इज बाय बर्थ एंड समटाइम्स इंग्यूनल हर्निया डेवलप्ड आफ्टर द बर्थ, या लाइक हो सकता है एडल्टहुड में हो गया या लाइक इन एनी ऑफ द मिडल ऑफ एज. ओके, सो इसमें क्या होता है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सपोज करो दिस इज द स्क्रॉटल एरिया. ओके, अब ये स्क्रॉटल एरिया में यहाँ क्या प्रेजेंट है, हेयर द टेस्टीज आर प्रेजेंट. Testes is connected with the abdomen by the help of spermatic cord. ये कौन सी cord होती है आपकी, spermatic cord. Testes are connected with the spermatic cord. अब ये ऊपर कौन सा region है, abdomen का region है. जब testes migrate करती है और scrotal region में आती है so यहाँ पर एक connective tissue का mesh बन जाता है. अब ये क्या हो गया, ये closed हो गया है. क्लियर? बट कुछ केसेस में अगर ये कनेक्टिव टिश्यू का प्रॉपर मैश ना बने, ये कौन सी कैनाल है, दिस इज इंग्यूनल कैनाल. ओके, इसी कैनाल के थ्रू टेस्टिस क्या होती है, स्क्रॉटम में अंदर आती है एंड ये जो कैनाल होती है ये सील्ड हो जाती है बाय द हेल्प ऑफ कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. बट अगर ये प्रॉपरली आ गई और ये कैनाल क्लोज नहीं हुई सो अ लूप ऑफ इंटेस्टाइन, a loop of intestine enters. यहाँ पर क्या करेगा, intestine का loop enter करेगा जिसकी वजह से this will become a painful situation and for that condition the surgeons have to do surgery. Clear? क्या करते हैं, hernia का surgery आपने सुना होगा, mesh, इसे क्या करते हैं, एक artificial mesh बना के इसको closed करते हैं. सो देखो इंग्विनल हर्निया, एक मैंने बोला कंजेनाइटल बाय बर्थ, एंड जो लोग वेट लिफ्टिंग करते हैं, यस, जो उन्होंने हैवी वेट लिफ्ट कर रहे हैं, तो बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेशर दैट गोज इन टू दिस स्क्रोटल एरिया देयर विल बी अ चांसेस फॉर द रप्चर ऑफ दिस इंग्विनल कैनाल कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. ओके, सो क्या कर सकते हैं, वेन एवर द अपलिफ्टेड द हैवी वेट, सो दे शुड हैव टू वियर अ टाइट सपोर्टिव अंडर गारमेंट्स, ओके, जिसकी वजह से ये रप्चर ना हो. क्लियर? अब ये जो आप देख रहे हो कि वाई की क्या रीजन है कि जो आपकी इस टेस्टीज है वाई दे आर प्रेजेंट ओनली इन स्क्रॉटम और कहीं क्यों नहीं प्रेजेंट है, बिकॉज स्क्रॉटम इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मेंटेनिंग द टेम्परेचर. स्क्रॉटम किसके लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है? स्क्रॉटम रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर Maintaining the temperature. Why scrotum ऐसा क्यों कर रहा है? So पहली बात ये, scrotum में deltoid muscles होते हैं. Scrotum have deltoid muscles. And scrotum में यहाँ पर क्या होते हैं? Sweat glands are present. And जो ये spermatid cord होती है, इसमें कौन सी muscles होती है? Cremaster muscles are present. These are the cremaster muscles. अब देखो, why the scrotum is able to maintain a temperature? If there is too cold situation outside, spermatid cord muscles are going to be activate and they shrink the size of testes. Why they are shrinking the size of testes? So it goes near the abdomen, and you know that near the abdomen this is slightly higher temperature which keeps the testes warm. Okay, if there is too hot outside, now the testes size are going to be loose, because that time deltoid muscles are working, and when these muscles are working they take away the testes from the abdomen area, and sweat glands are also going to be activated and they start releasing the sweat. Okay, and both cremasters and deltoid muscles, they are involuntary muscles. What are they? These are both are involuntary smooth muscles which is not under in your control, under controlled by your autonomic nervous system. Okay, next, see, this is the histology of testes. For example, I have a testes and I cut it into the transverse section. Okay, so what I see after the longitudinal sections of the testes, so you can see here, this is the structure of your testes. So outer side we have a covering of tissue, this pink one, suppose this is a covering of tissue, and this covering of tissue is tunica vaginalis. Okay, inner side also we have a layer of tissue covering that is known as tunica albuginea. This is known as tunica albuginea. And now this tunica albuginea makes further compartment. ये क्या बनाएगा? This makes further the compartment. You can see here this compartment, and this compartments are known as testicular lobules. This is known as testicular lobules. And how many testicular lobules are present in each testis? So आप लिखोगे in each testis there are 200 to 250 testicular lobules. Okay, maximum आपके 250 lobules होंगे testicular. अब now inside the testicular lobule, if you see here this coiled structures, what are these? These are the seminiferous tubules. यहीं पे sperm का production start होता है. These are what? These are the seminiferous tubules. अब now you can see here, this testicular lobules, they opens into this small ducts, and this small ducts are known as the rete testes. They are known as the rete testes, and all the rete testes, you can see here, this all are opens into the common one, which is known as vasa efferentia. This vasa efferentia, further you can see here, this duct, this is epididymis. this is what? This is your epididymis. Clear? And then you can see here this dot. This is what? This is your vas deferens. I hope I am clear to you. Clear? Now see, this upper part of epididymis, this is known as caput epididymis, okay? And the lower part of epididymis, this part, this is known as cauda epididymis, okay? See, caput means what? The caput means your head, okay? The lower cauda, cauda means suppose tail, okay? Next, this middle part. This middle part is what? This is the corpus epididymis. This is what? This is your corpus epididymis. तो याद रहेगा testes थी, testes का हमने section लिया, उसके बाद हमने देखा what present, outer side हमने tissue की layer देखी, tunica vaginalis, अंदर देखा tunica albuginea. फिर further we found out tunica albuginea makes a deep lobules inside it, जिसको हम बोलते हैं testicular lobules. In each testes there are total 250 testicular lobules are present, and in each testicular lobules 1 to 2, 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules are present, okay? And see, this testicular lobules opens into the small duct which is known as rete testes. Rete testes further open into the vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia opens into the epididymis, then into the vas deferens. ये पूरा आपको क्या दिख रहा है? This one is your epididymis. Yes, ये upper part of the epididymis is caput. This middle part is corpus and this lower part is your cauda. Clear? I hope I am clear. Next, suppose the transection of seminiferous tubules. Again, see, if I see the transverse section of seminiferous tubules. So, like this, suppose aap dekho, I told you, एक testicular lobules में कितनी seminiferous tubules होती है? 1, 2, 3. They are lined up by the germinal epithelium. Okay, which further rise to the sperm. ये germinal epithelium आगे जाके क्या किसको formation करेंगी? Sperm का. And now they are also lined up by the tall cells. Okay, in tall cells को आप क्या बोलते हो? Sertoli cells. And Sertoli cells का दूसरा name क्या होता है? Sustentacular cell. Okay, what is the another name of that? Sustentacular cell. नेक्स्ट आप देखो, इनके बीच में कुछ प्रेजेंट होगा, इन बिटवीन दे हैव अ स्ट्रोमल टिश्यू. इन बिटवीन व्हाट दे हैव अ स्ट्रोमल टिश्यूज. ओके, नाउ इन दिस स्ट्रोमल टिश्यूज टू सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट. एक होते हैं आपके लेडिक सेल्स. दीज आर व्हाट? दीज आर दी लेडिक सेल्स. लेडिक सेल्स का दूसरा नेम होता है इंटरस्टीशियल cells. Interstitial because between present and yes, they are also known as the interstitial cells. And they secrete what? They secrete the androgens. Androgens like your testosterone, yes? And also here your immunocompetent cells are present. Here your another cells is present, which is your immunocompetent cells. As name indicate, these cells are going to provide the immunity. Okay, हमने seminiferous tubule लिया. आप ये याद रखना, testicular lobules 250 compartments and each testicular lobules have 1, 2, 3 seminiferous tubules. क्लियर? एंड देखो उसमें क्या प्रेजेंट है? जर्मिनल एपिथेलियम. यहां पर ही आगे क्या बनेंगे? आपके स्पर्मेटोगोनिया, देन प्राइमरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट, सेकेंडरी स्पर्मेटोसाइट, देन आपका स्पर्मेटिड एंड स्पर्मेटोजोआ विच इज स्पर्म, एंड स्पर्मेटिड यहाँ पर इम्बीड होता है टू टेक न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम द सर्टोली सेल्स. Sertoli cells are also compared with the nurses. Why we are comparing with the nurses? Like nurse take caring of the patient, same here, this Sertoli cells, they are taking care of the developing spermatids, okay? And further, they provide nutrition to the developing sperm, yes? And unko mature mein bhi yehi help karta hai. Clear? In next class, we will going to discuss about the functions of Sertoli cells, and also we will going to discuss about the duct system, why it is important and what is the function of each and every duct. Okay, so thank you so much.